Hey everybody, it's Stephanie with I'll Buy the Popcorn. Thank you all for clicking on this video. If you're someone who enjoys talking about film, how about clicking that subscribe button? So today we're going to be talking about Prime's newest film, Herself. Herself is rated R. It is a drama. It is an hour and 37 minutes long. It did have a limited release last year in 2020, but it did officially come out on Prime January the 8th. And it is directed by Philippa Lloyd and it stars Claire Dune, who also helped write the script. She plays Sandra. Now, Herself is about Sandra, who is getting out of an abusive relationship with her husband. Now, Sandra is just trying to find a better life, not just for herself, but for her two younger daughters, just trying to figure how the system works, the housing system, just rebuilding her life, just trying to figure it all out. And not just rebuilding her life, but also building a house. That is the main focus of the movie, is her building this house, like her literally getting herself, getting free volunteers. As far as volunteers go, it really is, I don't even think it's 10 of them, to be honest with you. We'll get to them here just shortly. So like the first like 10 minutes of the movie, well maybe not even the first 10 minutes, probably like the first 5 minutes of the movie is pretty rough, because we do start off the movie with some abuse happening. The movie is not a happy, joyous type of movie in any shape, way, or form. Again, we are talking about abuse, about PTSD. It is a very depressing type of film. I personally did not cry within the movie. So we pretty much just have that abuse at the beginning of the movie, and then we do have the flashes in between. I am going to go ahead and say something I did not like about the movie with the flashbacks. We pretty much just got the same flashbacks throughout the whole movie, which is the abuse that we saw at the beginning. Not to say that because she only got hit once, it doesn't count or whatever. No, 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 no. Like, a man should never, ever lay his hand or a woman on each other. The way that the movie is expecting us to understand is that she is in fact in this really abusive relationship, you know, verbally and physically, physical abuse. So I personally feel that we should have had flashes of other times that he was abusing her, whether it had been physically or verbally. She did have like her emergency box. She did train her oldest daughter that when she gave her a secret code, that this is when she needs to go and find help. Maybe like that first flash could have been time that he either abused her verbally or physically. Maybe the second one could have been like another incident that was really bad that maybe left her with a black eye or whatnot. The third flashback could have been the mom prepping the oldest daughter with, you know, if this ever happens, if I ever give you this code, this is what you need to do. I just feel like something like that would have worked just a tad bit better, rather than just have seen the same flashes within the movie. Me personally, I'm just kind of nitpicking, but I feel like that could have just added and put this movie to a whole other level. Since I am within the things that I really did not like about the movie, one of the other major issues was the music choices. Like, I just didn't understand these music choices. I don't feel like they went at all with what was happening. Some of them were a little bit too uplifting. I'm just like, I don't know about this. And then finally would be the volunteers. I kind of wish we saw a little bit more of the volunteers, more of what was happening with them. Now, when it comes to the husband, by the end of the movie, you're gonna truly hate him. You already have that dislike for him because he is an abusive person. Once we get towards that end and that asshole prick move that he ends up doing, you're gonna hate this guy. Like, seriously, you're gonna be like, oh. Now, one of my favorite things that was said within the movie was during the courtroom. It was when the judge was asking Sandra some questions. This really stood out to me, and I'm like, yes, like, this is exactly what needs to be happening. Sandra ends up telling the judge, you're asking the wrong questions. Like, why do you keep asking me, why didn't I leave? Why didn't I do this? And why are you not asking him why he didn't stop? Why did he do this? And I think that whole scene right there was just very powerful, in my own personal opinion. I really loved it because that's so true. One, as a society, whether you want to admit it or not, regardless of what may happen, people always blame the victim. Whether it be abuse, whether it be a rape, it's like, well, what did you do? What did you provoke them to want to do this to you? And that's like a bunch of bullshit. It really is. People wonder why also people don't come forward when these things are happening because they don't want to be judged. They don't want to feel ashamed because these kind of questions are coming towards them. Now, before I officially do give you my ranking, if you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. Don't forget to give this video a like, comment, share, follow me on my social medias. Now, overall, I enjoyed the movie. I think it's a good movie. I think it is worth the watch. It is currently on Prime Video. It may not be for everybody. It could be a little bit tough, especially if you yourself have gone through an abuse. It is more than just building a house. It's about rebuilding yourself, finding yourself. And I'm gonna go ahead and give it a medium popcorn. If you've seen Herself on Prime Video, or maybe you caught it last year, let me know down below, what did you guys think about it? Did you like it? Did you love it? Did you hate it? Was it just not for you? Are you planning on watching it if you haven't yet already? Let me know down in the comment section below. And of course, until next time, I'll see you guys at concessions. Bye.